Hello, and welcome to One Stop Co-op Shop Streamed, your one stop for co-op news and playthroughs. And today we are playing through, what else? It's Friday, Marvel Champions Friday. I'm here with my homeboy Terrence. What's up, Terrence?
How's it going? Not too much. Excited for the weekend. You know, I'm enjoying the fact that, like, we have the stream, and then there's also, like, usually a new Marvel's TV show episode of some sort on Friday. So it's just, like,
I haven't seen this week, though,
Marvel
so
Day,
don't
you know?
Spoil it. Did you already see Falcon and was it good? I wasn't so sure about.
I feel like a lot of people aren't as hot on it. I mean, WandaVision was really just a pretty original show. So I feel like a lot of people are pretty let down with Falcon Winter Soldier, but I am enjoying it. I'll be interested to hear what you think when you do watch it. There's only like two episodes left, right?
Oh, really?
Like six in total, and this is four. So they're like, you know, it's got to come to head.
I gotcha. I did not realize it was so limited. Very cool. Well, this isn't a Marvel talk show. It is a Marvel play-in show. So we are going to start Galaxy's Most Wanted. So we got our Rocket and Groot decks. The mod, as you can see, is still not totally updated. So we're kind of fudging it at this point. But that's okay, because we have the comic book and everything, so let's get right into the theme of things. All right, Alpha Flight Station, Earth's orbit. Commander, we're under attack by the Badoon. We're sustaining heavy fire. Divert emergency power to the shields. I'm headed out. All right, so there's Captain Marvel over there. There's too many of them. Send the distress signal. Now, I don't know. I don't know the comic books very well, but I know the MCU. There's no way Captain Marvel is going to be, like, saved by the Guardians of the Galaxy, right? Like, that doesn't seem... that doesn't fit in with the MCU very much. She's kind of...
Yeah, I feel like in the Captain Marvel movie, she just, like, owned the Kree ship, right?
Right, yeah, I mean...
She's, like, literally just single-handedly took one out by flying.
So, I don't feel like that she would be... too distracted or need the help of the Guardians, but whatever, we'll go with it for the theme. We better get paid for this, Quill. Alpha Flight, this is Star-Lord. The Guardians of the Galaxy are here to help. I am Groot. So Rocket, you are you're stuck in the ship asking for help. All right, so if you don't know, so we are going to play through this campaign on Expert. Oh, yep. Here's a Milano here. Here's our ship. We're going to play through this campaign on Expert Normal or Expert Standard. So
standard,
Expert,
standard.
Meaning that we're going to play the villains on Expert. They're going to go from 2 to 3. But Normal or Standard Campaign means we're going to play on the like A side of this. So if you flip this over, there's actually a B. Wait. Is that right? Oh,
this
yeah.
This one.
Yeah. If you flip these over, there's a B side where it actually hurts you throughout the campaign. And so that just adds a little much. This is because we are playing with Rocket and Groot. We're not playing with some of the highest tier. And who knows? Maybe they end up being the highest tier. But we don't have a lot of experience with them. So we just want to have some fun with this stream. All right. So let's see. Record one unit for each player. Okay, so this is at the end.
No, that's
well,
victory.
Just so we know what our goals are for this mission, because you actually get units at the end, which is money, and it's kind of important to achieve these goals by the end, at least as many as possible. So you automatically get one just for beating it. You get another money, and this is in this campaign, you actually buy cards and upgrade your deck throughout, which is really cool. I actually like the way they did that better than Red Skull. So you're going to record the number of victory points you get, and you'll get victory points for completing side schemes or killing certain enemies, and then up to a maximum of 3, and then 1 for each player where there are no minions in play, so we want to clear minions before we defeat the enemy if we can, and 1 unit for each player if the main scheme is on stage 1B. So you don't ever scheme past this first scheme, you go to the second one, you get another unit for that. And then we'll talk about what happens with the headhunter and things like that. All right, so we did set up the whole deck.
Yeah. You also see in the Expert campaign, there's an additional... We both start with a minion in play.
Oh, yeah. So anything in gray text is for the Expert campaign. So again, Expert campaign makes it a little harder. We are playing against Expert villains, but not the Expert campaign, just a reminder. All right. Drang's overwhelming forces have mounted a surprise attack against Earth. Force response. After resolving step one of the villain activation, resolve a Badoon ship's charge-up ability. So Badoon ship's over here, charge up. Special, place a barrage counter here. If there are four or more barrage counters here, deal two damage, indirect damage to each player, and remove all barrage counters. So we're just going to get hit by this ship. So this is going to start with four threat on this scheme. And then the first player can exhaust the Milano to remove three threat from the scheme, though. So that's kind of nice. It gives you an easier way to thwart down. But the Milano, you'll also notice, if you just use it, it also could give you a free resource. So I like the choices they make with that, where you are choosing between getting a resource and doing something with it. In this case, thwarting down the main scheme. We also have Badoon's Blitz over here, standard mode only. Hinder 3, remember, 3 per player threat on it, plus the 2 on the bottom here, so that's going to be 8. So let's see, and it's worth a victory point. And when defeated, each player gets to draw a card. So we want to thwart this down. It doesn't do anything bad to us. I'm sure on the other side it does, but not for us.
Oh yeah, it definitely does. I think it, yeah, it's acceleration. So you can get the flavor of, like, when we defeat it, we discard a card, but on standard, when we defeat it, we get to draw a card.
Yeah, so, I mean, the expert campaign, in addition to, you know, having the villains be harder, it also makes the campaign harder. So we're not quite ready for that today. He starts with Drang Spear. That's right. Attach it to Drang. He gains Stalwart. So can't be. That's a new keyword. Can't be stunned or confused, but we can spend a mental and two fists to discard it. Get rid of that plus one.
It's a lot of stuff.
Yeah, I mean, we do have one resource here to start with. So we got that going for us.
The other thing to note is this side scheme does have victory. So if we do defeat it, we do get to... I think there is only 3 in total. There's this and the Badoon Hunter.
I believe that is correct.
So if we want that extra money, we do need to. That is the other big incentive.
Yep. And we played with these decks last night. I haven't changed my deck, and I guess you haven't either. So if you want to see, you know, more about these decks, but I'm playing Groot Justice, and Terrence is playing Rocket Aggression. So so there's interesting things here. I don't really want any of these cards, but I also don't want to draw too many good cards, if that makes sense, because I want to pay for the Helicarrier. I don't know if that makes any sense.
It doesn't make any sense. No, I mean, it's fine. You do what you need.
I'm gonna get rid of 2 cards here, and just draw 2.
There is a lot of.
Oh, okay. So I got an energy, so now I can pay for one more thing as well. All right, cool. Well, you are first player. You've got the Milano, so why don't you go ahead and take your first turn?
Sure. Do I start with attacking? I feel like I have to thwart. That is...
I mean, this isn't necessary, right? We just have to do this before the end of the game. There's no pressing need to do that. I mean, there's really only 4 threat.
I remember what happened with the prisoners.
Yeah.
Is that we're not going to clear that if we don't make it a priority. There's just going to be stuff that comes out, man.
All right.
I know how this game works.
Well, and don't forget, the Milano we can use to get rid of the threat on the main scheme, so... that we don't have to threat down ourselves at all. We can just focus on this. I mean, I'll be honest. I'm not going to help much with threat on this first turn. Actually, I'll probably do 2.
I figured it's
I could do up to 3.
Let's see. Okay, so... how much is down here? 8? Okay. So I will spend... unfortunately, Schadenfreude is in my opening hand, and I will use that to pay for my boots.
Yeah, so boots are a new item for those of you who didn't join the stream last night. when you take any amount of damage, you just exhaust them and discard the top card of your deck, and you avoid one of that damage. Pretty neat, like, auto defense. You don't have to block or anything like that. It's just getting rid of a pistol.
Yeah, I'm going to thwart for two on this side scheme, and then ready with I've Got a Plan to then thwart for three more. So five in total.
No, I already did the first couple. All right, so it's down to three.
And then I'm going to spend Salvage and the Milano to get rid of the Spear.
Look at you.
Wait, can I do that? Yes. Yeah, Wild. Wild gets me the two fists, and this already has the mental. And that will let me put this back on top.
Nice. So, yeah. So, Salvage.
And I'll hold on.
Salvage is a special resource. It's wild and a mental. And when you play it, you get to take the top or any tech upgrade from your discard pile to the top of your deck. So pretty neat. And how he did so much thwarting, I've Got a Plan. After you make a basic thwart, ready rocket and add one to his thwart value. So he thwarted for two naturally and then for three with the I've Got a Plan. So that was five. That worked out well. All right, so the way Groot works is he places growth counters on himself when he's on this side. So I'm going to add 1, 2, because it says I'm allowed to do that. Then I flip over, and when Groot would take any amount of damage, remove that many growth counters from him instead and prevent that much damage. So those growth counters are super helpful. All right, so sadly, I am getting rid of Wiccan. Oh, no, I'm not. Sorry. So that's three I spent there for my Helicarrier. Going to use the Helicarrier to... Oh, not yet. Not yet using the Helicarrier. First, I'm going to thwart for one. Badoink. And then I'm going to use the Helicarrier to pay for clear the area. Remove two threat from scheme. If it's the last one, I get to draw a card. So, boink. I get to draw a card. And that removes the...
I get to draw a card?
So... What?
I get to draw a card.
I did. I got draw a concussive card. Blow.
That's what the... No, I mean, but you get to draw another card. Each player may draw a card.
Oh, Badoon Blitz. Badoon Blitz. Sweet. That works out really well. Ooh. I guess I give you the plus one thwart, although I don't need to do that this turn. I want to put the vines out, right, to help defend myself. What's his attack? Three? Yeah, I definitely want to put out the vines. So I'm going to do that. I don't know if I hold Wiccan or not. I mean, Wiccan's good. But he's not great for this, right? I'm going to get rid of Wiccan. He's good when we have a lot of guys out. But
you did draw two cards?
Yep. One of them I used to pay for the Vine Shield. The other one was this Heroic Intuition. Because it would have just been Wiccan and the Vine Shield. All right, so let's ready up, draw up, and get ready for the next side. Ooh, I got some Root Stops. I got some We Are Groots. I got Flora and Fauna and Heroic Intuition. All kinds of good stuff in this hand. All right, so let's do the enemy phase, though. So enemy phase, they increase four threat. Oh, my gosh. Two per player. Holy moly. Then we add one to the Badoon ship. Then he is going to attack you. I think you're just going to have to eat this first one. I'll try to defend you better from now on, but...
Yeah. Cool.
I mean, the cool part is we got rid of Shadows of the Past, and it's only four. Come on.
I mean, it's five total.
Yes, five total minus the one for your boots. Four. So now he attacks me. I am going to defend. Shield Vine says I get to discard one of these growth counters for plus three defense. Definitely feels worth it. And so he only attacks me for four, but I would have lost that counter anyway, so it wouldn't have mattered. All right, now we take our cards. Ooh, a side scheme.
Cool.
Nice. I mean, sure. Exhaust the Milano, remove three threat from it. Oh, it's only got six on it. You can do three.
Oh,
well,
my
you
God,
can do
sick.
three and the mono will do three, right? Although then this is getting scary. You're gonna do three after I give you heroic intuition, right?
Sure.
Kind of makes sense. Oh, I am exhausted. So I think I'm gonna flora and fauna myself this time. I know sometimes we do it for the other person, but it gives me two growth counters and readies myself. I feel like that's better for me at this point, but we'll see. When reveal, place four threat. Oh, remember how I said that wasn't a problem?
Oh, 10.
Cool. Yep, yeah, we place four more threat on it. And again, for those of you who weren't here with us last night, there is a new symbol that could be on these side schemes. This one adds one boost icon to all of the enemy's boosted activations. So, this is worse. it's definitely worse. I'm not going to need my helicarrier is the only good news. I don't suppose you have stuff. Oh, you got a resource hand, which is what it is. Wait, do I get the Milano? Does it go back and forth? Oh.
First player controls
Milano,
right?
I did not realize that. That is
how
that
works.
All right. So I am going to flora and fauna myself. Do you want my helicarrier or do I hold on to root stomp?
I mean, I won't say no to it because I would like to at least hold on to one of my power and all of us. But also
gotcha.
Not
so
the world.
Flora and fauna for me, place two growth counters on Groot and ready him, or place two charge counters on Rocket's Rocket Raccoon upgrade and ready that upgrade. So. You don't have weapons out yet, so I'm not going to worry about that for you. So I will give you the extra thwarting, though. Right here. All right. So do I thwart for one? It doesn't feel worth it. I mean, maybe I just
Milano for
focus on the main scheme this time, and we'll worry about this later. Are you flipping?
I don't have to flip, but maybe I should.
Right, that's what I was thinking, because I can't defend for you again unless you have an ally. We're not really in any position to... well, you're going to have 8 health, I guess, with the endurance, but...
Yeah, so maybe I hold off on one more turn so
I
can
do I just
warp
for one? That doesn't feel good, although attacking for two, I guess, isn't much better.
Just punch him in the face.
Oh, here's the other thing. When he schemes, we add another one to the to that as well.
Yes.
So if we keep him from scheming, then we don't. This doesn't accelerate as fast. Although, I mean, it's not the worst thing in the world. Although maybe for you it is, because you're already down to not doing well health wise. Well, I am done. So go ahead and take your turn, and go ahead and take my helicarrier.
All right, so I will thwart for three. Do we
That's
do side scheme
choice.
On this one? Or do you want
I mean,
me to do
main I think scheme? You're fine doing side scheme now. I mean, in theory, I should be getting some, you know, some cards I can thwart with.
I feel like I have to play endurance here to get that three health.
And that you paid for that with the helicarrier.
Power and all of us to put out... Probably pistols.
I mean, you can put out both of them if you want. I mean, that will get rid of another power in all of us, but that's your call.
Yeah.
So the way
I could just use the battery pack to pay for the pistol and hold both of these.
Exhaust it. Move a charge counter from this. Wait, what? Oh.
No, I mean
To put out the gun and then, keep both of those. Yeah, go for it, man.
And then I'll hit him for two. All right,
Exhaust Rocket's pistol, remove a charge from it, and deal two damage. Now, this is something I got wrong, and I covered, the first time I played it, if you watch my first Rocket playthrough. So this does not have the keyword uses on it. So when this goes down to zero counters on it, it does not automatically get discarded. He keeps it in play. And that's good for Rocket's opposite side, which says choose and discard a tech upgrade you control and draw two cards. So even after you've used the pistols up, you could discard it, or stuff like battery pack lets you add counters back on it, things like that. So pretty cool. All right.
Where's Lockjaw?
Wait, did you do the two? Okay.
No.
So we're to two. All right, ready up.
All right.
And go ahead. All
right, there we go. Ironheart. Feels good.
Oh, you got downtime too. All right, so... Oh, yes, I got Fertile Ground. Thank you, thank you. And Concussive Blow. So... and I also have Mockingbird. So we'll decide whether we want you to flip or not, because, I mean, we have choices for that. And there's my plus two attack that
yeah,
I...
I'm not looking forward to this. Spatial positioning is going to be rough this turn.
Yeah, it's not going to be great, honestly. One, two, three, four. Add one here. All right, so he is going to attack me for three. I am going to defend and use one of my counters to block for six. All right, so then we will boost his attack. He's three plus one more, because this will add a star, so that would be four. So I block all of it. And then boost, put Padoon Grunt into play, engage with you. And now this Grunt is going to hit me and take off my last two Groot counters, which doesn't make me happy. I know they're called growth counters, but I like the term Groot counters. Thank you very much. All right. So that...
Nothing. So that is one. So four in total. And I...
For sure
I wanted... It is
yeah,
what it is.
That
you know?
Stinks, though, when you have two power in all of us in your hand. That...
And I was going to draw
it. And you would have drawn it with Ironheart. That's brutal. But, I mean, it's the right call, right? I mean, you had to take the less damage. All right, so let's go ahead and draw our encounter cards. I got mine. Let's see what it is. Oh!
Padoon Hunter.
Oh, here he is! What did you get? Surge. Oh, this is wonderful. This is going all according to plan. So this...
Here's that blockade.
Blockade, hinder two, so that's six. First player action, exhaust the Milano to... Oh, man. Yep. So that's a thing.
Yep.
All right. So, and you're probably going to have to flip, right? Oh, and you did surge this. Force interrupt. When the villain phase ends, deal damage to each player.
Yeah, the blockade was the surge.
Right.
Damage.
First player action, exhaust the Milano and spend two resources of any type to discard this card. Oh, so this just stays in play. Oh, awesome. Oh, well, your first player. Wow. All right, this went downhill pretty quickly. So the Padoon Hunter is worth two victory points, but he's villainous, meaning that he is going to draw a boost card every turn. And oh, by the way, shall we not forget that those boost cards all have plus one to them.
How much is that? Three. There's some seven. I can clear
you
that.
Can clear that?
Maybe. Maybe. Okay. So what is this? What is this? I can't clear it and clear Rogue Vessel.
Which is worse? Oh, by the way, we have to take one damage each. The end of the villain phase.
I did.
I mean, I feel like, I mean, unless we kill this Padoon Hunter, I feel like this is worse. I'm either going to stun him or, confuse him this turn. So if you are flipping, I will confuse him. If you are not flipping, I will stun him.
I think I'm flipping this turn. Well... I could stand if you confuse if you stun. I can probably.
I mean, I can definitely stun, and I will have Mockingbird as a chumper then.
Yeah, I do have. I also have Ironheart. Do I Ironheart Padoon Grunt to then get a card draw?
Oh, so you go over. All right, so yeah.
By
so
one.
Whenever you deal excess damage, you you get to draw a card. I mean, do you need the extra card?
I should probably do that, right?
I mean, an extra card's... Oh.
I have a two strength and a power and all of us that I can't use on anything. So.
I mean, go for it then.
I'll do the one.
And then
there.
The pistol does and two more. So that's overkill. So you get the draw card. Did that help? Oh, yes, it did.
Ooh.
That's a good one. That might let us get rid of this headhunter here, right?
And do I have to hold it? Because...
Well, I can give you
downtime. Okay. I'm not playing downtime this turn because I'm not flipping.
And then...
Okay. So this is four Thor off of this, and then Milano will do the three.
Okay, so you got rid of this. Does this give us anything? No, of course not. Why would it?
No, but it prevents you from taking
extra
boost from that.
Don't get me wrong. I mean, it did something. It's just now...
Gotta get rid of that spatial positioning.
We gotta get rid of 15 plus 4 more in a second. Oh, gosh. All right, so you did take my helicarrier plus your double resource to put out your gun.
Yeah, if you pull that. I'm going to hit him for 4.
Yeah, I still don't know if I can take him down, sadly.
Next turn, I'll be able to overkill
him. Yeah, I mean, for sure. The problem is this turn... Not so much. If I didn't have to exhaust to defend myself, but that's pretty standard for me.
We have two chompers,
though. Oh, I keep forgetting you don't put your allies up top. All right, so I'm going to spend 1, 2, and 3 for Mockingbird, who will put a stun out. Come on, stun.
What are you going to use it for?
I mean, I could do 1 damage here. And then you could... Either of us can kill her with an easy 2 damage, right? I feel like that's... I mean, unless you want me to start working on the scheme.
So I can scheme for 4, which means it's not great to use me and the Milano on it. So, yeah, I don't know. Maybe the Thor is the right call.
And then we can thwart the main scheme next turn. I mean, if we don't use her to chump.
Well, Ironheart first.
All right. Well, an Ironheart could remove that one, too. All right. So the question is, do I put Vine Spikes or Fertile Ground in? I feel like Fertile Ground's a better play. But, gosh, it feels bad to lose Vine Spikes this early. I feel like we're going to need to do damage pretty early. So the question is, do I just hold these two? I feel like I probably do.
Sure. Not right? Fine. Yeah.
Although we need more thwarting than attack right now, so maybe I do spend. I mean, I just feel like if I spend Vine Spikes, I never see it again. That happened yesterday and made me very sad.
Yeah, but you're not like... I feel like you're not swimming girlfriend.
No, well,
right
but
now,
with Fertile...
Either.
Ground, I definitely get that. I mean, I get 6 at a time when I flip. All right, but yeah, I'd rather have it go through my deck. I need some thwart events right now. Pretty bad. Well, I got a beat cop.
I don't disagree.
And I got a concussive blow. So that'll help you flip. I can't do both of them probably. All right, so I'm unexhausting everything. So we will start with adding 4 threat. 1, 2, 3, 4. This Badoon ship is about to go off next turn. So we've got to keep that in mind. Instead of attacking you, they are stunned. I am going to defend myself for 3.
Do you want me to chump his attack?
Yeah, that
first?
Makes more sense to chump him than...
on that.
I mean, you got...
Now, yeah, I mean, the question is what do you want to do here?
I mean, my 2 attack is pretty good. We can't both flip, though, and I need counters. Like, I'm not very good without... I mean, I guess I got Mockingbird to chump next turn, and you're going to be flipped, right? And I'll concussive blow. So as long as we don't get advances or stuff like that, we should survive. All right, I'm just not going to block this. I'll just take it. 1 plus 1 is 2. And then there's a star on this, which this activation is a scheme. It gets +2 boost icons. Thankfully, it is not a scheme. Holy moly, that would have been bad. All right. So that's that. So, yep, take our cards.
All right. Cool. I love Badoon Warlord.
I mean, thankfully you have your particle cannon here. When revealed, hero, the villain each minion engaged with you attacks you. Well, this is very bad. This is awfully bad. I'm going to block him, or am I chumping? No. Oh, wait. I schemed one. We didn't remove that. I guess I chump because I can do one threat myself, right?
Well, they're both attacking you, so you're picking which one you're taking.
Well, I mean, I'm clearly taking the one that is less attack, so I'll Mockingbird to block this one for 4 damage, so I hardly knew ye. And then the question is, do I block the hunter? And I'm going to not block it. So I take 1 plus nothing. Oh, if it's an attack, it gets +2. So never mind. That's 3. All right. So that's the end of the villain phase. So we do get to rogue vessel ourselves right here, which is awesome.
Yep.
I mean, it's happening. It's happening. I mean, something's happening.
I don't know, man. You need to flip, man.
I mean, we both need to flip.
Wait. Oh, well.
We both need to flip, right? There's no... You're first. I mean, you can't take another hit. Do you have an ally? Oh, you're going to get +3 hit points.
Well, maybe.
I mean... So what do I, concussive blow? And then flip and put Beat Cop out?
Probably.
I mean, I could do that. Do you want me to also punch him or no? Or heal?
I don't need you to punch him.
I mean, if I flip, I can heal. You don't need me to punch him? Are you going to be able to do 3 here and 4 here?
If I floor fauna myself, I can use my particle cannon twice.
Okay. So is that the plan?
That's my plan.
So you can hit him and you're fine. All right. So I'm going to flip. No, I'm not. I'm going to concussive blow. So that's 3 damage. Oh, no, I'm not going to be able to pay for Beat Cop. So hold on. That changes things. Because I need to do one more thwarting on this, right? So I may have to do that. Because I thought I was going to have enough resources to Beat Cop. But
I mean, you could use Milano if you want.
I mean, that seems stupid. So I'm not going to worry about healing myself. I'm just going to thwart for 1. So that'll get it within your thwart range. Now, I don't have to use Milano now, right?
No,
okay, so I'm going to flip. I'm going to add 3 counters. 1, 2, 3, because Fertile Ground lets me get a growth counter and draw a card. Oh, Death Focus is good. So I'm going to put it in. I'm going to hold on to Beat Cop. And you've got my Helicarrier if you want it.
I for sure will take it. So particle cannon to nuke your guy and then do 1 damage to him.
2 more victory points. We're up to 3.
I got to draw a card.
Does it
that.
Have overkill? Is that why you Watch do 2 off. More damage?
Cool.
Ah, yes. So wait, you only did 4 damage
I'm gonna
to
do...
him though.
He had 4 damage on him. So
1 extra.
I 1.
Okay, I thought you said 2 extra. I'm sorry. And you do get the overkill, so you drew a card, right?
I'm going to...
Nice.
I do Lockjaw. Well, I mean, I'm probably not going to pay for him, but Okay, so I'm using my pistol to do two damage here. And then I'm gonna lockjaw to play flora and fauna to put two more on the particle cannon and
Sounds
ready
good.
it. And then I'm gonna spend one to then nuke him so I can draw another
Nice.
card.
All right, so that's four damage, so that's two overkill, two rhino, and anytime you overkill something, you get to draw a card.
Yep. Do I live reload? Put the battery pack and just
I mean, you
get it
could.
down. But probably
The
need.
other option is, oh no, I can't do
I
this.
will
Yeah.
thwart. I will thwart the
Okay,
blockade.
and then as a first player action, quote unquote, I will Milano to get rid of three.
Can we afford? Can you
I have
afford
a
me
Helotaur.
flipping?
Oh, flipping? I mean, we're gonna lose this first stage if we flip. But, I mean, it's not the worst thing in the world. I
Okay.
mean,
I will
oh no, not
spend
necessarily. Not necessarily.
reload.
I'm sorry, because he's confused. We won't necessarily lose the first game. Because he's only going to thwart for max five. Now, that's assuming he doesn't draw an advance or something like that. Oh, but we're going to have to add four. Never mind. Yeah, no, never mind.
Yes. So I can't
I mean,
flip.
not if
Okay.
you want to save this. But hopefully I draw something to
All right,
confuse him
so
again or to prevent three scheme or something.
right, so I'll use the live reload, the re I will use
Yep.
helicarrier and reload probably to put out
Yeah.
skeleton so I survive this round. I guess I sack this to put out the battery pack.
I'm good with that one.
And I'll put one more on here. And then next turn, I can at least ditch the battery
Yep.
pack.
Yeah, and you'll flip over next turn for sure. So, well, not for sure, but hopefully for sure. All right. So let's unexhaust everything. I get to draw five cards, which is way better. Ooh, power of justice and speed and under surveillance. I mean, can't pay for everything. But,
All heroes, chances of me playing that,
I mean,
almost zero,
yeah,
right?
I think you're getting rid of that from your deck, right? I mean, we kind of talked about it last night. Definitely not the best thing for your deck. All right, so let's see. Where are we at? We're gonna add four threat to this game. One, two, one, two, three, four. Then I am first player, so he is going to try to thwart against me, but cannot because he's confused. Now he's going to attack you. And we are praying here. So that's four. So that's three to you. I mean, pistol's not great, but there are certainly worse things you could lose. There are better things like Hall of Heroes, too, though.
Take your card.
Right. Let's do this. You want to get yours? Oh, this is fine. So do I lose three counters? I think I lose three counters. Or do it?
Yeah, I think you
Well,
have
yeah,
to because
because
you
I
need
mean I can
heal.
heal for four, so yeah, I'd rather lose three than four. I usually like this when I'm
Okay.
on the other side because it lets me use my Fertile Grounds. So actually, I don't want to remove it from the game, so I didn't remove it from the game. I kept it in there because it lets me flip to use Fertile Grounds before I take my turn, which is great.
All right,
Oh,
I
wait a
get
minute, wait a
this
minute, wait a
platoon
minute. We both
engineer,
take
which is
two indirect
perfect.
damage. Oh! We would have done that
Sure.
at the beginning of our turn after we added threat. So actually, I only lost one counter with that because I would have taken two on my Groot counters here. And then I lost one, and as long as you lose at least one, the card doesn't gain surge. So that was great, actually. That worked out really well. I mean, not for you per se. Although you've got this to get rid of this guy. After Badoon Engineer engages you or activates against you, resolve his charge up ability. Oh, so we add one to here. Now, unfortunately, I don't have, I mean, I do have under surveillance, and I do have speed. So we'll see. But go ahead and take first player.
All right, first, and Milano.
And I'm hoping for some other double resource draw here with my Fertile Grounds. You mind if I do that real quick? That'll help us make our decisions. And I'm just gonna add all three because that's a free action too. Root Stomp. Not exactly what I wanted, but if you can't take care of this, I can. Well, I mean, obviously you can, but.
All right, so I'm going to do 2 damage to this guy.
Oh, did we take a damage at the end of last turn?
No. At some point,
you're
going to
flip right now,
right?
I think, right?
That is a thing.
I kind of think you have to. I mean, thwart it down as much as... Oh, you can't thwart because you have to heal. I mean, you have to... Oh, no, you don't have to heal. The Rocket Boots will save you.
No, it's Hero Interrupt.
Oh,
Interrupt,
right, so
man.
You have to heal this turn. There's not a choice about it. So you have to play downtime. I mean, let's go ahead and pay that Hall of Heroes. We know that bad boy's not going to matter. What are you paying for? Oh, you going into the fray?
I'm thinking about it, because that would be 5. Thwart down.
I mean, that
drop
seems
down
good.
Nine.
The only negative is I'd love to get rid of this stupid thing at some time, but it doesn't feel like we're going to be able to. Oh, and you're going to be able to Milano it for another 3, right?
No, I think I have to... Are
I
you...
can give you the Helicarrier.
Wait, are you using... You're using... Okay. So I'll spend these 2 to into the fray. So that is 5 off of the main scheme, right?
Yeah, because one...
And I will Moment of Triumph.
Don't forget
you
get to draw a card as well.
Yeah. Valorant. I'll use that to pay for my downtime. Thank you very much. Are you comfortable with me flipping with down 9 or you want me to thwart?
Oh, how did you get life?
Moment of Triumph.
After you attack and...
I was maximizing the amount of healing I could do off of that.
You know, I can Ironheart. I can defend you for 1 more turn. Now that you're not going to die. I think that's okay. Is that okay with you? You don't sound real happy about it. Oh, you want to draw 2 cards. You want to get rid of something and draw 2 cards, right? Is that where we're at here?
I would like to. I don't need to. I don't have to. So if I thwart and I Milano, I can basically get this down to 1.
Yeah, don't do that. Go ahead and don't worry about it because I'm going to have under surveillance on it in 2 seconds. Either that or I speed. And...
Right, so I'm Milanoing
it.
Yeah,
Milano
down
to 6 and go ahead and flip.
Okay, so before I play downtime, then I will flip.
The battery pack.
And I will pitch the battery pack. To tinker with it. Cards.
Spider-Man.
I think I just hold it.
Hold Spider-Man and
hold
Genius?
Spider-Man. Yeah.
I mean, it feels good. Yeah. I mean, it doesn't feel great, but it feels pretty good. You're still going to get 2 extra cards next turn because you can get rid of your pistol.
Yeah. Cool, and then I heal.
What's your max
5.
Hit points now? Between
16.
I mean, that,
isn't
that's,
it right? Wait,
that's pretty
15,
good.
All right, 15.
So I am going to heal for 4. As much as I would love to stay on 2 hit points, doesn't feel like the right move. I think I don't play. Do I play speed or under surveillance? I mean, they basically are going to do the same thing, right?
Under surveillance, probably.
And then I can play Beat Cop. I feel like I want to play Beat Cop.
And Fruition, basically?
Yeah, I mean, that's basically it. I can't Ironheart, and unless I draw into a double resource, and that seems like a gamble.
Did you want me to Particle Cannon, I guess, real quick before you do your
Why
turn?
Would you? Does it matter?
Or you want me to save it? It just
I mean, let's
damage.
Save it at this point. Does it? I mean... So there's three for a beat cop. Beat cop's gonna thwart.
Alright, I'll move the one.
Yeah, I'll fruition to get two more counters. I mean, that seems alright.
Cool.
I mean, I feel way better now than I did 2 seconds ago. We both have 11 health-ish.
Alright, get me a minion for this moment of triumph.
Ooh, I got my plus thwarting stuff. And my unexhausting stuff. I would have to use the Milano and my Helicarrier to be able to play Fury.
Probably not worth it.
But maybe.
But
we'll
maybe.
See. All right. So, what is going on here? First thing, we add one counter and two. So we haven't done... Oh, no, not two, four.
Wait. Yeah. Go. Is this here? No. Can I retcon something actually real quick? Can I do... What do you think about...
Because we both would have taken a damage at the end of the turn.
Yeah. What do you think about me getting rid of that? Like the genius that I drew? Because it's not a hero action.
But you would use the Milano to thwart the main scheme.
Yeah, I'm saying instead of Milanoing the main scheme.
So go ahead and add three more.
Yeah. I think with the surveillance van, I'm okay with that.
All right, you drew back up. Draw that one card. All right. Yes, that was a little bit of a cheat, but that's okay. This is I'm okay with that. All right.
Caught.
So you are first player. So go ahead and ready the Milano now. Ready everything now, right? So we didn't take that one damage at the end of the turn.
Yep.
So we're both sitting on 11 life. Go ahead and heat.
Well, that happens at the end of the villain phase.
Yep. So he is going to boost. So he's thwarting for two, or scheming for two, plus two more is four.
Did you?
I did. I didn't add a second one, because whenever he schemes, he adds one to the ship as well.
Yep.
So 16. So we have four more before it's trouble time. I am going to block for six damage. Go ahead and boost it. Resolve the Badoon ship charge-up ability. So we each take two damage.
Yeah, just
you can heal again. You're not flipped. Now
that
does not get rid of the counter, so they're going to do it again next turn, which means I'm almost out of counters again already.
Wait, what? Resolve the Badoon
charge-up. So
ability.
It would have gone to four, and if there were four more, I'm sorry. So it charged up. Yep. So it goes back to zero. So that's the good news.
Yeah, I was going to say, what?
That is not as bad as I made it sound there.
Okay, so take your encounter cards.
This isn't great.
This goes up by one.
Is that bad?
Cool. So he just says the two.
Alright, so we're not dead yet, is what you're saying.
No. I have a plan.
You have a plan. I mean, at least one of us does.
I've got a plan, literally.
Oh, I never unexhausted.
Well, at least that effect is...
I did defend.
Doesn't do anything.
One revealed hero. You may exhaust the Milano. If you do not, the villain attacks you with plus one. I mean,
I'll exhaust it.
Yeah. All right. So that means we can't use it to thwart the main scheme, but I mean, that is what it is, right? All right, so it's my turn.
Yep.
I mean, I still feel like we're in okay spot.
It's your turn.
I mean, I'm not doing great right now. Do I put counterintelligence out? And then flip?
Bold man. Sure.
Well, how much thwarting are you going to be able to do? You know what? I'll give it a turn.
Nine. I can do nine.
I'll give it a turn. That'll get more cards out of my hand. What do you think?
I mean, you should probably
play counterintelligence. But if...
even if you don't.
But I mean, if I play counterintelligence, I'd want to flip to, because otherwise I'm hanging on to these two cards. I mean, I might not need the, well, that one readies me. I might not need the Thwart one.
Wait, so if you play counterintelligence,
I could get rid of the Thwart one, I guess, right? I mean, you've done a good enough job thwarting.
Sure. I mean, you can play this for free though, right? Because you have Death Focus.
Oh, I forgot Death Focus. Nice. All right, never mind. All right, well, I'm definitely playing this one then.
And then you just pitch these two.
I'm sorry, I forgot Death Focus. I did forget that.
And if you really want, you can helicarrier this one.
I don't need to. I mean, it's not doing anything. The real thing I'd love to do is flip just to play, get this card played this turn and draw 7 cards next turn and get 6 more counters. That would be nice, but I am afraid because of the main scheme being so high. You said you're taking 9 off of it, though?
Yeah, because I have a plan, so that means I'm going to have to work.
Do you mind if I flip?
4 and then
would
5.
That make you angry?
9.
It's
going to
go up 4.
9 puts at 9. Come up with.
I'll give you the helicarrier. I mean, do you need the helicarrier?
Let's see.
I'm just hoping.
How much do you need me to thwart a lot, right?
I mean, oh, what are you thinking?
I can put Spider-Man out instead of follow through, and then he can thwart for 3. So I can thwart for 2.
So you can thwart for what?
12.
All right, so.
Yeah, I need your
You can add my helicarrier, and I'll flip. Good?
Okay. Yep. And
yep.
Draw a card.
Oh, I forgot I have a beat cop, by the way.
Yeah.
That's a little help. Boom. I have helped. I don't feel like I've helped very much, but.
Oh, wait. Oh, yeah. I forgot I can.
Oh, yeah.
This.
And draw 2 cards. Draw 2 cards. Nice.
One. Oh, that seems great. Except I can't do anything with that,
right? In a minute you might be able to. Nope.
Okay. Wow. Cool.
I mean, I feel like you're getting Spider-Man out and doing a bunch of stuff. Yeah, I feel pretty good about your turn.
All right, so I have no tech upgrades to shuffle back in. So 1, 2. Well, I don't feel great about losing all my moments of triumph right now, but whatever. All right, so Spider-Man's coming in. We want him to thwart,
well,
right?
Why don't we see where we're at?
And say damage. We'll have to declare what plus.
Oh. Yeah, I mean, let's go ahead and do thwart, and then we don't have to worry about it. Hopefully next turn I get an I am Groot.
All right, so he thwarts for 3.
Pound it.
So
I mean, I feel like at this point I'm just going to be attacking and doing a bunch of stuff for the rest of the game.
So I'm going to thwart for 4, and I ready, and then 5 more.
So you thwart for 9 more, so down to 5.
Yep.
I mean, it seems good.
And then I'm going to put fall through out as well.
Seems good, although we're both going to get extra encounter cards this turn. Oh, wait, I have a helicarrier for you. So hold on to one of those moment of triumph.
Yeah, may I save one of my moments? Yeah, I feel like they're going to come in handy.
Yep. All right, so.
Fall through will be super nice now,
what?
Too. Fall through means
I just
get more healing.
Absolutely.
And more everything.
All right, so you're done? All right.
Yes.
Let's ready up. Let me go ahead and draw 6 cards now, which is my entire deck. I got an I am Groot, the thwarting one, unfortunately.
Nice. I do a 4 Fauna as well.
I have a concussive blow, though, and another beat cop. So if you want to flip, we should be good with all of that. And I got a Coulson, so I could get another one of these counterintelligences. All right, so I'm going to use this so that only adds 1 threat to the scheme because it would normally go up 4. That still does that. I am first player, so he's going to scheme against me for 2 plus nothing.
Do you have your extra card, by the way?
What do you mean? Oh, no, I did not. Thank you for reminding me. It's not my extra card, by the way. This activation is an attack. Nope. All right, so that's two more. One, two.
Do you like this? Do you like this ally hate right here?
Yeah, gains overkill, piercing and ranged. Yeah, no, no yeah. Bueno.
Didn't see that coming.
Yeah, no, we all knew that there was going to be lots of ally hate coming. Nothing. So two damage.
It's always nice. I that is such a crappy card to get. Like on the. Okay. I feel like I've done my.
You took your two damage or no?
At this point, I feel okay with. No.
Yeah, no, no. You've definitely done more than your fair share of thwarting here. Night, buddy. Did you like the movie?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Good. We'll talk about it tomorrow.
Oh, and guess what? So you know how I was reading an essay and all that stuff about the book?
Can we talk about it tomorrow, bud?
They put quotes from the book into the movie.
Oh! They did quotes from a book you did an essay on in the movie? Sweet. We'll talk about it tomorrow. I'm excited to hear about it. All right. So what just happened? I'm sorry. All right. So let me draw.
I just did my attack, so.
Sweet. Card gain surge. See? I knew there was a reason I was on my alter ego side. Just so I could get... Oh, gosh.
More cards. You sure you want that surge?
No, I did not. Peril. Oh, so I can't read this to you. So I can exhaust Milano, spend two resources, or stun the first player.
As you read it to me?
I'm going to get rid of Beat Cop and this, or Concussive Blow. I don't want to do any of that. F you, Milano. All right. Spend or deal three damage to the first player. I'll take the three damage. I'm okay with that. Badoon, retaliate one.
Cool.
All right. Wow.
Badoon's
minions, anyone? Hey, remember that Hall of Heroes? I mean, theoretically, I could beat cop this grunt if you want me to. I could also just attack for 2 to 4, depending on what happens. Well, you're first player,
okay.
So let's go to you. Here's the Milano. Enjoy it.
Thanks.
You can have my health here if you need it.
I feel greedy this game, but I feel like I'll take it. okay, so blaster pistols. Do you think I just take out one of these guys?
Yeah, go for it. And then, oh no, I would hit one of these guys and then hit him with your big hitter for the extra damage, right? I mean, don't worry about the grunt. Like, I'll figure out a way to take care of the grunt, even if it's just poking him myself. I'd rather you take care of these guys.
Okay. So,
although I think you want to take care of mine because you're gonna flip, right?
Sure.
So if you flip, we'd rather mine be the one that's dead because that prevents an attack against me. I mean, one threat on the scheme. I don't think we're going to worry about that.
You did your.
I did my growth stuff. Yes.
Already. Okay, so he's 5 health, right? So I need a blaster pistol. And I take a damage, puts him at 2. Then I'm going to Partle Cocaine in him. How much would that do?
5, because it does 4, but it's overkill. So that's a 5th one, because you have Follow Through, which is another new card. When your hero attacks and deals any excess damage, increase that amount by 1. And then, overkill, you're doing 3, and you do 5 damage, so 2 to the boss.
Okay, and then I'm going to chase him down.
All right, so 2 to the boss, and then 2 from the scheme.
Okay. And are you okay with me leaving Badoon Sentry?
Yeah, no. Like I said, it's one threat, right? What do we care about that? You know what I mean?
Or should I just
take care of him? Or not? I won't take care of him, but it's one threat. What does it matter? I'm going to take care of this guy, the grunt, for sure.
Wait, what are you doing for the... Oh, wait, I get draw a card, right? I just need to die.
I feel like you do that and you use that extra one to heal. You thwart or attack, and then you heal, right? Because Battle Fury will let you ready yourself.
Yeah.
I feel like that's pretty good. You don't need a four on Fauna.
I'm just trying to maximize.
Don't worry about it. Or I got a helicarrier for you, don't forget.
So I can four on Fauna to ready this particle cannon. And then I can nuke the tuned grunt.
I mean, grunts
are
worse. I mean, I could get rid of Beat Cop to get rid of him. That seems like a little bit of a waste. But I could.
Let me see. I can also, feels bad, but I could attack this guy.
For three? Or no, two. And then nuke him?
Yeah. And then foreign fauna.
I mean, but foreign again, this is literally one threat. I wouldn't worry about that. I really wouldn't.
Okay.
Because, I mean, if I get a stomp, I kill him next turn in one card and only take one retaliate, right?
Yeah. So do I just form Fauna? Do you want your helicarrier then?
Or I don't care. I mean, if you want... It's your call. So, did you use the helicarrier for that?
I can spend my Battle Fury.
All right.
So you can have it.
I mean, I don't know if it helps my turn or not at this point. I mean, it will help my turn. Like, I'll make sure it does, right?
Yeah. Get a card. Cool. So, I'm going to kill him. That's four on top of that, which is two, and then I heal for three. Up to nine,
so wait,
right?
Why is it four on top of it? It's five, right? Four plus one.
Well, it's four.
Five,
yeah,
so
five.
It's three
so
extra.
It's three. So I heal for three.
And you draw a card.
Yeah.
Okay.
It's a strength. Well,
you now know what it is.
And then Spider-Man will attack for two.
Oh, we forgot about Spider-Man.
Well, I did not forget about Spider-Man. I was going to potentially ping Badoon Sentry, but then
that would
the
kill
problem
him
is basically
kill yourself.
Like,
yeah, no,
it kills.
No reason
yeah.
to do that. All right. You good? You flipping?
Yeah.
I mean,
yeah.
I'll concuss him. It's not a big deal. I concuss him.
Should I heal? Yeah, should you want me to thwart? Heal up to 15
yeah.
health? 14
Why
health?
Not? I got the helicarrier now. All right. So let's just start with that. Well, I already got my counters. I am not going to heal. I am going.
You sure?
I mean, I'm not sure, but I feel like I can attack for four, which feels decent, right? With this. Or I could thwart for three or heal for four or whatchamacallit for four. I did use this. So I don't think I heal. I mean, six is fine. I'm fine. Everything's fine.
Okay.
All right. So I'm going to spend one, two, and... Well, that counts as a fist.
And I'm good.
So two, concussion. So that's three damage and confused. Then... I am going to... Oh, it looks like I am going to have to spend... Oh, no, I got helicarrier. Sweet. Yes, that helicarrier definitely helped. Let's put out a second beat cop. And I'm just going to beat and beat. Come on. So you remove two more threat. And then I'm going to attack, spending a counter. Where is it? Oh, did I don't have the attack one. No. Son of a gun. So I healed.
So maybe you healed.
And I'm up to 10. And then I'll fruition to get three more counters. I mean, I could have thwarted, but I feel like that's excessive at this point. I mean, you're our thwarter. Yep. Ironically, even though I'm the one running the justice deck.
Am I?
All right. So that's five.
Honestly, you don't have that many justice.
I don't. You're correct. They're more counterintelligence, confuse, stuff like that, and beat cops are really my...
So you actually don't have a good way to help me.
Well, except I give you this.
I feel like it's a lot of Thor
prevention. Intuition at the beginning.
Yeah, but I'm saying, like, if I need you in the pinch to actually, like, put out a bunch, like, unless you have this thing, you can't do it, right?
I mean, I can do it for three. Oh, did I forget the... I keep forgetting to use Death Focus. Let me put it somewhere more useful, because I don't know... No, I did beat cop, and... Yeah, no, I didn't do any stuff that would have used it. I have I Am Groot, though, and a Root Stomp, which feels good. I feel like I'm going to do some damage here. All right, so let's go ahead and go through the enemy phase. So first things first, 1, 2, 3, 4 over here, which does set off the Badoon ship. So we each take 2 damage, which doesn't make me very happy. All right, so then he is going to scheme against you, but doesn't because he is confused. By the way, let me check the chat. The chat's just quiet tonight. We got a lot of people watching. Please feel free. Have you guys played Galaxy's Most Wanted yet? What are your thoughts on it? Love to get some feedback on it. All right, so then he is going to attack me. I am going to defend. Spending one. So defend for 6. Attacks for 3. And put a Badoon Grunt into play, engage with you. Great. So then attacks for 2 more. This just has not worked out very well.
It's grunts, man. It's swarm.
They are. Go ahead and draw your card. Oh, did you add the 1 extra threat for this guy? Yep.
No.
Yep. It's all good.
Okay.
Oh, we shuffled, so we're going to add an acceleration. That's you.
I guess. Yeah. No way.
Cool. And mine is Hero. You may exhaust the Milano if you don't. Yeah, exhaust it. Milano hasn't done a whole lot this game except for prevent terrible, terrible things from happening.
I mean, the Milano's like going on a run to make the rocket follow it, right?
Yes, missile. No, you're the rocket. That's the missile. Is that a missile? What is it? I don't even know. Special delivery. It's no bueno is what it is. All right, so back to me being first player, right?
Yep. I am going to pitch my pistol, though, to draw 2 cards.
And I'm exhausted because I blocked. But that shouldn't matter. I'm going to spend a double resource. I am Groot the sentry, right?
I am Groot the Sentry. How much
I'm sorry, Root Stomp the Sentry.
I don't need you to.
Okay, so do you want me to just Root Stomp him?
Yeah, okay. Man.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
I mean, just look at my hand. I got a battery pack. A battery pack, a pistol, and a
reload. This is awful, but I think I'm flipping again in counterintelligencing. I spent a double resource. Oh, I could remove threat counters to We Are Groot us, too. Why don't I do that? So I got this. We Are Groot. So go ahead and take tough, and I'll take tough. Or do you want Spider-Man to take you and you to take tough?
Whatever you want.
To Spider-Man. Double chump for you. I feel like I'm just the enabler. So now, because of that, I'm going to flip and put up counterintelligence, right? You good with that?
Sure. Right,
so I'm gonna flip. I'm gonna get three counters. One, two, three.
And well, I guess well, depends on what you get, right?
Card I draw. I mean, do you mind if I keep the Groot?
Keep it.
Do I keep Groot or well, Root Stomp is gonna be five, and it gives me a counter. Groot is gonna be six, assuming I lose no life.
Yeah.
So where are we at with that? What do you think?
The I'm Groot then. Okay. Keep the I'm Groot.
All right. So and I'll use a Helicarrier and Root Stomp to put Counterintelligence out. Or do we even care about Counterintelligence and just say forget it, keep both of them, and do 11 damage next turn? And what?
It's up to you.
What are you feeling?
Well, I'm not thwarting this turn.
Oh, so never mind. All right, so we will put Counterintelligence out. Better safe than sorry on that one.
Don't get a beat down, though. Cap.
Good call. All
right. Okay.
All right.
I will flip. And then I will...
Oh, crud. Are you going to be able to kill him too, or no? Okay.
Yes.
All right. Totally spaced on him. Because he would be two threat, which isn't wonderful.
I'll just nuke him right now.
All right. Shooting him with your pistol?
No, shooting with my particle cannon.
Three overkill? And you get to draw a card?
Oh man. I will pistol this guy and then use the boots to prevent the retaliate. So he's taking two.
You get double reload.
I will do this and this.
Wow, you are lots of resources.
But didn't I just put a battery pack? Yeah, battery pack on top to put in. Where is he? Where's good boy?
Is he discarded?
I'll just search. You want to just pull him out? No, I'm just looking for good boy. Lockjaw.
He's such a good boy. Love Lockjaw. That's why I love Lockjaw. You just get a handful of resources for no reason. And, Lockjaw feels real good in that situation.
Do I just spend these energy things?
I mean, why not, right?
To just have an epic turn? All right,
I wish
so
I had
battery pack
for you.
Yeah, that's fine. This is three on here. Two. Gonna spend this battery pack to charge it up.
Yeah, particle cannon's real good.
And may I just use a reload to reload? And then hold on to strength?
That's your call. I mean, having to reload next turn is terrible, but I guess you do have a limited amount of...
Yeah, I just don't have many tokens anymore. And then this. So this doesn't go down, because I'm going to spend that. And then this will go down, so that's six damage to
which
loss.
Is overkill, so don't forget to draw.
No, hold on. Wait, hold on. I'm not going to spend the reload to... Wait, do I... I draw one more card.
Yeah, you're going to draw a card right now.
So I'm going to overkill this guy. So that's going to do two.
Oh, you don't kill him. That's right. All right, so you overkill him first. So you don't take the retaliate because he's dead. So he had two on him. So that means he had three life left. You did four. Oh, hey, Verga. Very good here. Wee Lad, just played Rocket so far in standard Drang. Lots of fun. Glad to make it to the stream tonight. Wee Lad, we are glad to have you on the stream tonight as well. Thanks for coming. Yeah, it's a, it's tough. I mean, this is tough. That's why we're playing expert, but we're, you know, we knew we put ourselves in for something here. So what do you...
Watch us and do two.
Now, I never took the damage off from him. How much overkill did you have on it? Two, right? One, two. Yeah. Lockjaw takes him down to one. So close. But that's really where you want to be, right? Like, that way you don't have to deal with the extra stuff, and next turn you just plink him. So yeah. I kind of feel like that's where you always want to be. What did you draw, by the way?
I don't have good
battery pack.
The card I put on top. Battery pack. Yeah.
I mean, you're going to flip next turn, I'm assuming.
I don't have to.
You don't have to, but. So I draw five, and I ready myself. All right, so I am first player. So first things first, we had five threat to the scheme, but we're going to do minus three of that. So we just add two threat to the scheme. We are going to add one thing to this. Then he is going to scheme for two plus. Resolve the Badoon ship's charge up ability. So we actually have to do that two more times. And we add two threat to the scheme. All right. So he's attacking for three. Are you chumping?
All right.
Spider-Man?
Spider-Man.
Why is it whenever...
Wait, no, no. I'm not going to block. Sorry. I have my own tough. Spider-Man can then help.
If we need. Right, or cards. Just chump two more times, right? Like, nothing wrong with that. Hey, so far we haven't had to flip the Milano. We got that going for us. After Badoon, Grunt engages you. If there are no other minions engaged with you, deal yourself a face down encounter card.
Have we been doing that?
No, because he's always come in through the star ability, the boost ability, literally every time so far.
It's still a force response. It's a force response.
So we've missed that. I'm sorry. It's above the line. That's weird. I mean, it's not weird. It's bad. I think we resolved mine because we're still in the resolving cards phase, right? So I just got this in this phase, so I think I resolve mine. Badoon, force response. After Badoon Engineer engages you, activates ship. Resolve Badoon ship's charge up ability. All right, so we each take two damage.
I'm going to put one on Watch On.
That's smart.
And then I will boots the other one.
That's terrible. Oh, I got Flora and Fauna. So it's not the worst thing in the world. And Groot Stomp. So I got some stuff.
Can I exhaust the Milano?
I mean, it's your call. I mean, you're going to get it next turn also. So. All right, you good? All right, first player. There's your Milano. Enjoy. I'm going to go ahead and add my three counters.
I'm going to kill the boss by nuking the Badoon Engineer.
Okay. So that's three with what? Two overkill? All right.
Yeah.
So let's advance the boss. And he comes in tough. When revealed, discard the top four per player, so that's eight cards of the encounter deck. Each time a minion is discarded this way, put into play engage with the player who is engaged with the fewest minions. Huh. It's not great. After Drang activates, resolve... Oh, so attack or scheme now. He's going to... Alright, so you get the first one. It's four per player, by the way. Not just four. So it's eight. Force response. Badoon Assassin engages your hero. It attacks. We'll have it do me, right? Because I'm not a hero.
Well,
easy enough.
How many more?
I think that was two, so two more.
Okay.
That's a shame. That is a shame. Wow. All right. Scene has changed. I do have two beat cops, so let's not forget that. I mean, I can just take out some of these guys with the B-cops. Like, I don't know that their one thwart a turn is as important as taking out. So I can take out the grunt and this guy, right? Pretty easily.
Yeah, it makes me wish I kept my live reload.
I mean, that was going to happen, right? It feels like that was going to happen. I mean, I do...
Do I just
I have flora and fauna. If you want me to play it on you. Unfortunately, it's a hero action, so I can't play it now. But
do you think I haul heroes?
Go for it.
Do it finally.
Why not? Because you're gonna flip this turn, and you should get three, right? I'll help you get to three as best I can.
Okay.
Wait, why is this exhausted? When did you use this? Oh, that's right. I forgot we had another guy.
That's what drew me to Hall Heroes. Okay. Kill one dude.
Well, you may as well kill him, right? So that's one counter on it.
Yeah. No, I'm going to kill the other guy.
Why?
Because then I get a draw card.
Yeah, overkill. Forgot. Yep. I'm so used to wanting to kill it exactly. And not.
No, I don't want to kill exactly.
Oh, and you got to chase him down. So you want to play that right away? Or are you going to use that to pay for stuff?
Are you going to use your
Helicarrier? You can use it. I don't even look. I just see what I have left after I'm done. Now, don't forget, I am probably going to flora and fauna your gun here.
Okay, that's fine. Do we need chase him down? Because I kind of want to hold on the battery pack.
Are you going to be able to thwart at all this turn?
No. I don't have to flip down, though.
Okay. I mean, I can thwart for three. And Wiccan can thwart for one. Oh, I do have two doubled resources. Actually, I can pay for Fury this time for the first time in a long time. I feel like I do that, right? For sure. So Fury can thwart. Yeah, we got some stuff. We're good.
Okay, I'm going to enter the fray Badoon Sentry. So he's out.
What?
And that means I'm removing two off of the main scheme. And I draw a card.
Yep. Yeah, this follow through is good when you continually overkill stuff.
Hellcarrier is just not worth it anymore. No. This point in the game. So I'm going to put two on that. And then do I just kill your dude?
I mean, yeah, if you want to load up all heroes.
So there we go. And I assume you nuked that my guy in front of me?
Yeah, I mean, do you want me to root stomp him?
You'll be able to
nuke him in a second, right?
I don't have to. You can now just form fun on yourself, right? Like, I have the three. Like,
so the question is, do we even worry about him at this point, or just go hog? Oh, hold on. Those two extra points of damage. So we did two. You did two and two, right? To him, the first two would have taken off tough. The next two would have taken down.
No, I don't. I don't have overkill by default. It's only from this, so I didn't do any extra.
Well, for some reason there was four missing. I think you had done an overkill earlier in your turn. Brant says,
"No, overkill earlier put him into this new
kill the warlord, keep the sentry," is what Brant suggested there. What's the sentry got? I guess he's only a 1/1 is why Brant said that. And that would have been one extra point off of the main scheme if you had done it that way. Did you want to do that? Instead of taking a 3 attack damage?
Do what?
And overkill?
Just keep the sentry around?
I mean, he's only a 1/1. That does make more sense, right?
Sure, whatchamacallit. Into the Fray does 6.
But we just took another threat off the main scheme. Right? Because he had one more. Yeah. One less life. Good call, Brent. Oh, Sentry protects against...
He's saying it protects against the Badoon Grunts who come out.
And he's just a 1-1. That makes a lot of sense, rather than having a 3 attack person sitting around. See, Brent, that's why we invite you around. Thank you. That's smart. I like that. We just got to start pounding on him at some point.
Well, yep, I think that's
I'm
you.
Getting there. So you don't want me to get so your particle cannon up and going?
No. You give yourself your growth counters and do anything.
All right, well, yeah, let's see how this works.
I'm brute stomping.
So first things first, I'm actually going to pay for Nick Fury this time and draw 3. Oh,
what?
I got 2 I am Groots.
Wait, did you want me to flip?
Oh, are you flipping? It's up to you, man. Go for it. I think we can do. And then you're gonna discard something to draw 2.
No, I'm doing.
You
can
do it both times. You got an extra battery pack, right? And pistol. It's your call.
Yeah, but I can just use. Yeah, I'll just do it now. Get that in my discard pile.
Do you want to play any of that other stuff? You could. You want to play Ironheart? With my helicarrier?
No.
Okay.
No.
Right. Yeah, are you going to discard that rocket launcher? Or... All right, we'll figure that out later.
I'm going to keep my rocket launcher for next turn because I'm discarding
All right,
something.
So back to my turn. So I did draw the 3 extra cards. I mean, I could put out.
You can I'm Groot twice?
Oh, yeah, that's what I'm saying. Yeah, no, that's twice. Happening. So let's helicarrier for... Oh, whoa, let's not Flora and Fauna yet. Let's attack for 2. Makes me sad I did not get that attack card out, but that's all right. So then I'm going to Flora and Fauna using the helicarrier to get 2 counters and ready myself. I'm going to use Deft Focus and Speed to pay for 1 I am Groot. So that does 6 damage. Feels good.
Did you? Oh, you're 2 attack.
Yep. And I'm gonna just spend this now. To I am Groot again. 6 more damage, and now I can start using my counters. Unfortunately, I don't have the attack one, but since I don't have, I'm gonna thwart. What do you think about that? Take 3 threat off the scheme, just to be a little safer since you're flipped down. Or do I just have? Now, Fury can attack just as strong as I can because I don't have the stupid attack thing in. I have 2 beat caps, by the way, too. So let's take 2 more. Oops, went the wrong way there. All right, so that's 2 more off. I mean, do we care if we get 3 more off? Or do I just attack? At this point,
I'm just
attacking. 1, 2, 3, 4. And then I got Root Stomp for next turn. And I got a Fury block, and you still have Spider-Man sitting around. Did you want to do anything with Lockjaw this turn? Okay.
No.
All right.
I don't want him to shuffle in.
Good call. I mean, I could remove 2 counters to ready myself. We know I don't have any more I am Groot, so I could do 2 more damage.
I don't know if it's worth it.
2 more damage. I mean, I don't have any more I am Groots. They're both literally... gotten out this turn, so all good. It's ready up. And draw up. Oh, there's my attack of it. There we go. Yay. All right, that's all I care about next turn. I mean, this game's over. I mean, we have to survive. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. One on this, and then he is going to your first player. So go ahead and boost him. Oops, sorry. Oh, put him into play against, engage with you, and then don't forget his force response to add another threat card here. Did I speak too soon?
No, I don't. I have another minion.
Oh,
that's exactly why
we
didn't kill him.
Brant, Lashing Vines, you got this. Good game. Yeah. Thanks, Brant.
So three thwart on top. Right?
Yes, plus 1 from actually plus 3, right? Oh, did you already add the three? Yeah, you had the three from him. And then we also add one to this. So did you add three more? So it was at 11, and then, yeah, you added six.
Wait. I thought you had it down to six. Six plus three is nine. Nine plus
yeah,
six.
Yeah, no, six plus five, don't forget.
It's 15.
You get an acceleration here. That's where we should be. I'm pretty sure. Okay. Then he's going to attack me. I'm going to chump with Fury, obviously, because Fury won't be here in a second anyway. Yeah, we definitely had it down to five, but there was a lot of threat added this turn. I mean, that shouldn't matter. Oh. And that shouldn't matter, right? Badoon Warlord, attacks again, overkill. Yeah, yeah, it's all good. Oh, the villain and each minion engaged with you attacks you. Thankfully, that wasn't you.
Spider-Man.
Oh, yes,
Spider-Man's
yes, yes.
Me.
Woohoo! I was about to say, that doesn't make me too happy. But, yeah, no. We finally got rid of that tough counter on Spider-Man. All right, so let's see if I can finish this off. Yeah, so I got my vines. So, oh, I am first player. I got the Milano. Oh, here we go. I got this. Just for fun. All right, clear the area. That's not going to happen. So I'm going to do Deft Focus.
Wait, we want to kill... You don't want to kill him until we're done with this turn, because we want to get rid of all the minions.
You are correct, but I am not going to be able to kill him anyway. I can do three right here. Well, hold on. Let's be smart about this. Beat Cop number one takes care of this dude. Beat Cop number two takes care of this dude, right? Yeah. I will do...
So you have to hold your actions back until my turn or something?
Is no, I can't. I'm not going to kill him.
How much
three.
Can you do?
One, two, three. Then I can spend two more to ready again. Which is this one. Yep.
Don't you have to exhaust this?
Yeah. And then we will root stomp. Oh, no. All Ironheart first. So that lets me draw a card. Oh. Wait, that didn't do exactly what I want. Sorry, I'm using my helicarrier. To root stomp for five. Then we are going to attack for three more.
Three more?
Yep.
Oh, two of you. Okay.
You got this.
Okay. I drew
so
my
beat
cards.
The game says just finished precons okay. Versus expert Zolo with Rocket and T-Rex. Wait, and you beat that?
How do you play as T-Rex?
I guess it's custom stuff. I don't know. So that's what Steve said from Beat the Game, and Brant said, "Oh, nice." Let's see. Beat the Game said it's French. Good learning experience.
I'm doing two damage to him.
We got
to
do a marathon. We got to do a marathon session. Nebula and Ronin. Yeah. Good luck with that. That is going to be a, I don't know. I mean, fun and long and that would definitely be a marathon, but it's fun. I mean, I'm liking the new stuff. I do think it is definitely more challenging. I mean, certainly much more challenging solo. At this point, I'm pretty convinced of that. But, I mean, it's no cakewalk, even duo here. All right, where are we at?
I did two damage with rockets, pistols. I used my Hall of Heroes. I discarded, so I have plus five cards on this turn. I will... How much else do you have? That much? I will Particle Cannon... this guy, which kills him.
Oh, with the overkill? Yep.
And
four
and
plus.
Overkill.
Yep. And nice. That is all of it. All right, so let's go ahead
and I draw a card.
You get to draw a card. So let's see. We got one for beating it. We got all three experience over here, so that puts it up to four. We got each player, if there are no minions in play. So, yep. that would be five monies to spend right now. One, record one for each player. The main scheme is on 1B. Yep, we never got past the first one. So that is six, which seems good. All right, so we got to mark that we killed the Badoon Hunter. Now, we don't have a record sheet for this, so I'm just going to killed Badoon Hunter. Done. All right. Oops. Don't want that. All right. So now we get to spend. All right. So this is another fun part of the campaign. Let's see. The market over here. Oops. I brought the whole bag. I took the whole market. I got the whole market in my hand. I got the whole market. All right. Should we just skip all the way to the sixes? Or you think you're going to get something cheaper?
What are you thinking of?
No, we're doing, yes, we're doing standard campaign, but we are doing expert villains against the standard campaign. We did not feel as comfortable doing our Rocket and Groot decks against the expert campaign at this point. I mean, we might have got away with it, but we played it a little bit safe here with how we did it. But we are fighting against expert villains. Six is the way to go. Yeah, there's a six card that I absolutely loved. I think it does two damage a turn. Like, it's just a gun that literally does two damage every turn. So let's look down for the six cards. The seven cards aren't great, actually. If you look at them, they're all one-time effects. So ready up to three characters and remove it from the game. Choose a player. That player may add up to three cards from their discard pile to their hand. I mean, they're fine, but they're like one-time effects. Deal five damage to the villain and remove five threat from the main scheme. I mean, if you can do anything, that one seems pretty good. Drop to your maximum hand size and remove this card from the game. So yeah, all these are like removed from the game after you use them. Whereas the sixes seem good and they stay around forever. So exhaust the targeting screen to remove three threat from a scheme, or two threat from a scheme, three instead if you're first player, basically. Exhaust navigation column, choose to discard one card from your hand, discard the top card of your deck instead if you control the Milano to draw a card. So it lets you cycle a little bit. This is the one I was talking about, do two damage or three if you control. I mean, I feel like we should get the mounted laser and the targeting screen, right? Or exhaust cargo hold, heal a damage from a friendly character if you control the Milano, heal a damage from your identity. That's an additional damage, I believe. Yeah. I mean, I feel like mounted laser and targeting screen are pretty good. Which one do you want?
Doesn't matter.
A cheaper one then, if it doesn't matter to you. I will take the laser.
Aren't they both six?
No. One costs one to put into play. The other one costs two to put into play. I will take the mounted laser, but I can't take it because I guess you were searching the deck first. So go ahead and pull both of them out. Doom is impressed with your victory. Do you dare take on the next scenario? We probably won't do it tonight. I don't know. What do you think? You up for staying up a little later tonight? Doing one more?
I might. We'll call it for tonight. Just yeah. It's like.
And to be honest, I'm hoping the mod gets updated by next weekend because it's kind of a pain to do it the way we're doing it right now. There was another mod that had all the stuff in it, but like we've had to custom construct our decks. We've had to pull these out where this mod's so good where usually it just sets everything up for you. It's kind of a pain right now. So I'm hoping by next week we will get the better mod up. All right, so there we go. Mounted laser and targeting screen. So we got those two. All right, everybody. Well, I think that's going to do it for us tonight then. Do you want to give your first impressions? I mean, we've played a little bit now. Do we want to give some impressions of what we think of Galaxy's Most Wanted so far?
Sure. Kick it off, Peter.
I think it's what the game needed. Right, there are people out there, and Steve from Beat the Game is one of them that can do really cool stuff, right? Like do like all the arrows in a turn for Hawkeye and things like that. Because that says to me that the challenge level is probably not right, if you can do all these cool things and, like, you know, and still win the game, and, like, that means you're messing around a little bit at other points of the game. So I think they needed something that upped the difficulty. The thing I'm not satisfied with this set right now is I don't think it's balanced right for solo. And they should know that this game is mostly played solo. So that bothers me a little bit. Like, I wish they had balanced it better for solo. Don't get me wrong. I took the standard decks, like, right out of the box and got up to Nebula with Rocket before I gave up, and got past Nebula to Ronin with Groot. Now, I probably could have won had I played enough times. It just feels like it's so swingy. They start with so much stuff on the board. I feel like multiple players have much easier time getting rid of more stuff at the beginning of the game. I feel like one character, it's really hard to do that. And certainly out of the box. And Rocket out of the box is kind of weird. He's got all those cards that are restricted, that also he has his regular weapons that are restricted. Like, the hand cannons are fun, good weapons, but I don't feel like they really go with his deck. Now, that happens a lot, right? With other stuff too. I think hand cannons are a fun addition to the game. It sucks that they're in Rocket's starter deck. Again, if you bought this as your, let's say you're a new player to the game, you bought the core box, and then this was your first thing you decided to do because you love Guardians of the Galaxy, I think you're going to have a real hard time with this. I think Red Skull is definitely a better introductory campaign than this one, but I do think this is what's needed for expert players and players who have played a lot. I mean, there are people who have played hundreds and hundreds of games. And even the modular encounter sets, I think, are really good to add to your previous villains. And, you know, we did it last night on the stream last night, and that was a lot of fun too, right? So I think they did a lot of things right with this game. I would not recommend this as somebody's first purchase after the core box, though.
Do you think you can beat Go Through if you bought this right after core and you don't have most of the card pool?
It'd be interesting. I'd have to remember what cards are in the card pool. I don't think Groot actually... I think Groot protection is probably fine. I mean, I got through... Well, I was doing standard, though. I think standard you could probably get through with Groot protection with whatever, you know, just making some tweaks from the core box.
Because you wouldn't have... You wouldn't have in your Justice deck, for instance, Concussive Blow, because that came with Ms. Marvel. Obviously, Beat Cop. Counterintelligence, you wouldn't have. Actually, like, almost all your Justice cards besides Power of Justice, I think, is the only core set Justice card you're running. I think that is correct.
Yeah. So, I don't know that. Like I said, I wouldn't recommend this as a first purchase, for sure. I think Red Skull is a much better introductory campaign. But I think, you know, for people who have played this hundreds, if not thousands of times at this point, I think it is a good place to go with the game. What are your thoughts on that?
Yeah, I mean, this reminds me of, I think, like, in Lord of the Rings, as a Lord of the Rings player. This is about the time in Lord of the Rings, actually, when I got into it, was the third cycle. And this is, I guess they don't like using the word cycle, but I feel like they use it anyways. But this is the third box, right? If you count the core as the first one. And so we're on, like, kind of the third set of kind of content drop. And Heirs of Numenor in Lord of the Rings is, like, if you bought the core set and you bought that and you're trying to play it, you had no hopes of winning. And it definitely was, like, this big, I think, kind of speed bump. There's a pretty famous quest in there called Into Ithilien, which is the second one, that was just notoriously hard. And I think this is kind of similar. It's just like it is this thing, and you're going to have to figure out a little bit, like, how to kind of work around, I think, Galaxy's Most Wanted, right? Like, introducing stuff like Ally Hate and other things that I think were heavily abused, I think, in the early part of the game.
Yeah, I mean, I think it, this would, and I don't know, because I haven't played leadership against it, but I think with a lot of the Ally Hate that's in here, I think that it's good for the game. I do think Ally Hate is good for the game, because I do think they can be too powerful. So, you know, I don't mind a game making you learn new tricks, right? Because allies were meant to be something that come in, kind of do their thing, and then kind of go away. And they do kind of do that, but they do it in a way that is really... just keeps you around longer than you should, right? So I don't know.
Yeah. Yeah, there isn't as much ally hate as I think in some of the Lord of the Rings shadow cards, where like I think some of them are just like discard an ally literally as the shadow effect, which would be the boost equivalent. They don't quite have that.
Right, but yet. There's like do one to all your allies and stuff like that. I don't know if that's from this specifically, but I know they've added more cards like that. And in Lord of the Rings, your allies will never die, right? They don't hurt themselves when they do stuff. So they needed to just get rid of them. Where here, doing a damage to them sometimes basically means get rid of them. And it could mean get rid of a bunch of them, right? If a card that did one to every character you control came out right now, you'd lose both of your allies. So I think it might be equivalent sometimes.
I don't think it's quite the same, like just because you also there's so much more action stuff you have to do with Lord of the Rings. I do think it's interesting, like the shadow effect cards that randomly give you overkill, that you, well, I guess like part of it, I think that's what's like not as interesting, is that it's random, so you're still gonna do it, right? Like you're still gonna chump with that ally with one health
because it's what you do.
It is a random effect. Yeah. So I don't feel like they're doing a lot to kind of, I think, deter that behavior necessarily, except the collector.
Sure. Well, yes. Collector definitely stops you from from chumping with allies, because every time something's removed from the board, it gets put into his collection. You guys will see that next week. We'll go on to Collector is the next one we do. So, although, I mean, yeah, then you just got to pay two more resources to get it back. But definitely, there is a lot more ally hate with Collector.
I think what's interesting about Collector is that he, I think Tough generally is not considered nearly as valuable. And I think Tough becomes a lot more valuable in villains like the Collector. So it kind of changes. And I think that's what's kind of neat and fun and what I'm looking forward to, is like cards that maybe not as interesting in the card pool normally, given normal circumstances, become really interesting in certain scenarios. Where it's like, oh yeah, like that card, like feel like invulnerability feels super overcosted. I think it still even might be in the collector, but you know, like stuff that does get tough potentially, like that protection card that gives tough to multiple characters becomes much more interesting now, right? Like you can now defend with an ally and they might not die, or defend.
Yeah,
with
I mean, we did that just, this like, game, right? I mean, you had a tough. Spider-Man had a tough, you know, so they just stick around longer, which is nice. You know, I think tough on an ally is real nice, actually. I thought it was kind of goofy before, but, I mean, the ability to take a whole extra block, you know, a whole extra villain attack is pretty good. I mean, it's basically as good as a stun.
Yeah, it also shuts
and
down
and shuts
overkill.
Down overkill, right. Yeah, so...
So I think that one boost card also has piercing, so it does not shut down that card.
Yeah. But anyway, I think it's a good step. What do you think about the units? Like buying cards with units, stuff like that, rather than...
I mean, they kind of had that in Rise of Red Skull a little bit.
Well, they just gave
you
cards,
have
right?
Cards
here,
pick,
it's
but...
the better you do, the more money you get, the better stuff you can get.
Yeah, I think that's interesting. I think I like it a little more than how Arkham does it, where it is like a campaign pull that's unique to the campaign that you're playing. I think that potentially makes the campaign a little less replayable, because it's the same pull versus in Arkham, I guess, where you kind of are building a deck around it. I feel a little less pressure to kind of like prep a deck basically that is built from start to finish, right? Where I'm counting for all the upgrades that I'm getting for those cards.
Yeah.
But yeah, I mean, I think it's interesting. I think there's a lot. I haven't kind of looked through everything yet, but 28 cards is a decent amount of cards.
Yeah, it's four at every experience level. I will tell you that I've gotten six only on this first mission. I've never gotten six past this first mission. This is the second time I've gotten six out of three campaigns that I played on the first mission. So I think if you're going to get it, it's going to be the first one. But it's kind of random, right? Because it depends. Like, I typically get this, but the Headhunter is very random whether it comes out or not. And you guys will see as we go into the next campaign, because we beat the Headhunter, it actually tells you right here at the end of this campaign, because we beat the Headhunter, we're going to add a second Headhunter card. So this Headhunter side scheme is very interesting. You start with only one, but every time you defeat it, you get more cards. You get the next card in the set. So it kind of becomes more and more treacherous as you go down. I mean, gosh, look at this henchman, which is the second to last one. So if you have already defeated him three times, you put this in addition. Surge, 2-1 with 8 health, and patrol. it's three icons on the bottom. So the more times you defeat the Headhunter, but it makes sense also because the more every time you defeat the Headhunter, you're getting 2 experience. So you're getting better cards in your deck, but they are also getting better cards in their deck, which I think is kind of neat. I like how they do that.
So what you're saying is I should be playing Scarlet Witch instead?
Oh, to get rid of those and use their icons against them?
No, I mean, just like you want those three, just like more boost icons.
Well, yes. But look, there are a lot of star icons.
Yeah.
I feel like they did that.
Maybe we should run that target acquired basic card that allows you to
I know, right? It back. Feels like it, you know, and that's okay. I like that. You know, like you said, they're giving more value to cards that didn't have value in the past. So that's a good thing, in my opinion.
I feel like Kree Fanatic put a lot
well,
of value
but
on
Kree
that
Fanatic
card.
Was a print and play. Not everybody's going to have that, of course.
Yeah. Why don't you cut Nick Fury and put him in? Put that like target acquired.
I mean, Fury came out, I guess, just the one time in this game. But
yeah, like I cut my Hall of Heroes. You cut your thing. We put one copy of those cards in each.
To cancel boost icons. Now watch the rest of the game. They're not even going to do anything.
Well, it's not boost icons. Boost effects.
Yeah, I mean the boost effect here was kind of. These are interesting, right? Like, it does better against attacks, or it does better against thwarting. I mean, I like that. I like how they're playing with that a little bit. They're not just icons. And again, I think that's to specifically counter Scarlet Witch, which they knew did use those boost icons. Of course, they're adding boost icons in with the side scheme. Now, I wonder how that would work. Huh. How do you think that would work? Would those count for her too?
Well, it doesn't count. It doesn't cancel the boost icon. It just cancels the boost effect.
No. I'm talking about Scarlet Witch when she's flipping cards off the top. Would she get the benefit from the icon? So let's see. Amplify icon increases.
No, there's a fact.
Oh, boost cards turned up during the enemy factor activation. It is very dark black.
Yeah, it's very specific.
So yeah, it's not going to help Scarlet Witch to have those out. But yeah, so they've added less boost icons, it feels like, to some degree, but they're adding more star effects. So I'm okay with that.
Yeah, I mean, I think that aligns a lot with how Lord of the Rings works, because they don't actually even have icons in Lord of the Rings. They only have shadow effects, which will then say the plus, like basically the boost icon equivalent. And I think the game is much more interesting when it is card text, but it plays a little slower because you have to read it. I do think they kept it simpler, and I think you're starting to see some of that more complexity as the game is.
Yeah. I mean, the question is, at what point do you have to go back to simpler or risk not being unfriendly to new players, right? Because if new players are going to want, you know, let's say I came in because I love Guardians of the Galaxy, and I'm just going to get the core set, and I'm going to get Guardians of the Galaxy, that might turn me off to the game completely, right? Because it's much more complicated. Not much more complicated, but yes, much more complicated, but also much tougher, right? I mean, if these were your only other missions you had a choice of playing and you were a new player to the game, it might be tough. So I wonder if they could even, and they're never going to do this, because, well, I mean, they haven't done this in the past, certainly. I wonder if they could put, like, a difficulty rating on the box and, like, a hero rating. But I feel like they don't want to do that, right? They don't want to admit that some heroes are worse.
Yeah, they try to do difficulty ratings in Lord of the Rings, and part of the problem is, like, you put a thing down because in your playtest you thought this was the result, but then when it goes out in the public, you're, like, really
right.
wrong.
But they can't be as far off as having nothing, right? I mean, it can't be like, this is the hardest mission we have, and it's, like, the easiest. I mean, at least it'll be in the general vicinity, right? You could even do hard, medium, easy, or whatever.
You'd be surprised how far off they were in Lord of the Rings sometimes.
Okay.
Like, I think Caleb really dislikes putting difficulty on
yeah,
stuff
well,
now. After
yeah,
his
and I mean,
Lord of the Rings.
You can't blame them for learning from their lessons, right?
Yeah, well, that and, like, part of the thing that's challenging now, right, is that as the card pool grows, what is easy and what is meta is not always clear when you're designing the cards, right? Like, because they said they're designing the cards 2 years in advance before it gets printed, right? So, I feel like it just becomes, like, you have rotations in CCGs, right? Because it is unreasonable to ask a designer to keep the entire card pool in memory.
Yeah.
Right? Like, as they're building stuff and the
combos.
Well,
and you can't playtest every combination as well.
Yeah, and then, you know, you always have your, like, Sestan equivalent, who's this guy in Lord of the Rings that basically breaks the game because they don't put limits on stuff and things like that. And so then cards always get errated.
Well, I feel like Steve
him.
From Break the Game is that guy in Marvel Champions. He's putting up videos again of him shooting Hawkeye's entire quiver in one turn or attacking for like 900 damage with Quicksilver, right? Like, just boosting those things like crazy and taking full advantage of it and like unexhausting yourself 500 times. I mean, you can't do that,
yeah.
I don't think, without leadership. But yeah, I mean, there's definitely going to be people like that in every game. And, you know, that's awesome. You know, those are different things that you don't always get to see. So, I mean, then there's guys like us that are basically barely trying to beat the the standard campaign.
I do think Caleb does draw the line a lot of times where he will not errata something if that is not a thing you would reasonably do. Like,
right.
Like, there was some stuff one time when he went to this conference in Germany for Lord of the Rings where, like, someone went up to him and showed him this, like, broken combo. And then he asked, like, would you ever play that? And the guy was like, no. He's like, then I think it's fine.
Right. Well, I mean, to some degree, there's a point with that, for sure.
So. Yeah.
It was a
fun
one, though.
Kind of like everyone else.
So, I mean, are you having fun as an experienced player now? You know, because I think a lot of the people watching the streams and, you know, us have just played so many games of this. Are you happy that this expansion came out? Is this what you wanted?
Yeah, I definitely am. I do. I am sad a bit because we got a taste for Kang and I really liked what they did with Kang.
Yeah.
I haven't played through the entire campaign because I am going through it on Expert. True Solo, which I hear is the worst thing to do in this campaign.
yeah, good luck with that. I mean, you'll probably be fine until you get to Ronin, and then that'll be interesting.
It was really hard, man. That like
yeah, I mean, if you're having trouble beating Collector, good luck. I
mean, yeah,
you'll
but,
see. We should
yeah,
we should
I mean,
beat Collector pretty easily next week. I think you're right. There are some random draws with Collector where he'll just put cards in the collection and you'll just lose because of that. I mean, that's.
Yeah, I've lost like 3 or 4 times that way.
Well, you just got to keep it low. I mean, that's the bottom line.
Well, that, I mean, it's just like you just can't afford to, right? Like, you got to threat the main scheme. You got to.
Yeah,
like,
I mean,
you already got a card out, and then, like, you killed this guy that put 2 cards in, you know? It's like.
Well, but I feel like he doesn't have that many minions, right? I mean, I think they knew. I feel like they don't have as many minions and side schemes in that one. Because I feel like they knew that it would just clog up the collection in like 2 seconds if they did. So, hey, sweetie.
Hi, honey.
Hey.
You're missing a kid. Do you know?
I don't know where our kid is.
All right.
But that's worrisome that we are missing a child.
You don't like to get that random, like, do you know where our kid is?
We've got did you hear my wife? She said, that's okay. We have a spare. That is not okay. So I guess that is my cue probably to call it a night. But yeah, no, I've had a lot of fun with this campaign. It is definitely, I feel like it's what the game needed. I do wish that True Solo was a little bit easier, but I don't know. I just wish they would have realized that, like, I don't know that 50% of their players are True Solo.
I feel like
they've never
catered towards True Solo in all the co-op LCGs that I've played. Like, it is possible, and it's not, but it is not a thing, I feel like, that, at least for Lord of the Rings, that has, is, like, actively, like, I think they expect people to play it, too.
Right.
Like, two-handed, I mean, Lord of the Rings is very common, even for solo players.
Yeah, I mean, I think for this one, too. I think two-handed solo is very common, but even Doom is scared when the children are too quiet. So we got Victor Von Doom over here. Did you find the child?
We are 2 for 2.
We're 2 for 2. All right. We have all the children. We're back in business. Two kids. Although it is like 11:40. We're at East Coast time here. And our children are not asleep yet. That worries me for tomorrow. Now, my kids aren't young. They're 9 and 13. But, yeah. We might have some grumpy children if it's 11:40 and they are not yet in bed. So I should probably go take care of this. I start at 9:30 because that's when I'm hoping they're going to start working their way toward bed. But, yeah, not tonight, apparently. All right, Terrence, man. Well, good seeing you. Thanks for playing. It was awesome. We got 6 experience out of our first mission. So just as a reminder, again, we are playing standard. We're playing expert, meaning expert villain, but standard campaign. So we're not carrying over damage. Not that we had damage to carry over, but we're not adding extra stuff, which this campaign does. So, for example, on this mission, we each would have had an extra minion at the beginning of the game. So, yeah, we're not doing the extra... Oh, and this would have been... Or this thing would have been flipped over, too. So instead of when we defeat it, we draw a card, it would have been an acceleration, and when we defeat it, each player must choose to discard a card. Oh, and it's hinder 4 instead of hinder 3 also. So, yeah, I mean, these are just way worse on the other side.
I think we might not have kept it on 1B if it was on the other side on expert
with an acceleration token and more threat on it. That would have been tough for sure.
And you discard a card when you defeat it instead of draw.
Yep All of those things are bad. I mean, we might not have lived, who knows. Certainly might not have gotten 8 all 6 experience. So
right, that, and then your health matters too.
Yes. Yeah. I mean, because at one point you were down to 1, right? And I was down to 2?
Yeah, I was down to 1 health.
And I was down to 2 at one point. Yeah, no, there's no way we survived. I think we would have lost had we done expert. But it's fine. It's fun. I mean, I wanted to have it be a fun challenge for us every week. I certainly don't mind winning. When I play co-ops, that's how I prefer to play. You know, I know people are like, oh, if I win, then I don't think it's any fun. I just want a fun challenge and feel threatened the whole time. See, some people want to feel really good when they win because they don't win that often. I want to feel really good or really bad when I lose because I don't lose that
often. I want a mix of both. Like,
yeah.
Like, I think there's, it's good to have the things where just like, you know, like we do this in Lord of the Rings in my play group. Just like sometimes you just want, you know, it's like been a hard week or whatever at work. You just kind of want to sit back. And we have some like cafes where you can get beer or whatever and like just like have an easier time.
Yeah.
And bring like not like A tier decks, right? Like top tier decks. And other times you just want to play like thematic decks, right? And then other times you do want that challenge. You're just like, okay, well,
I feel like I'm more in the case where life is hard. I don't want my co-ops to be hard. You know, like work stinks, having kids is tough, like all this stuff. Yeah, they, you know, there's a lot of joy that's brought into life too, but I don't want to go and get my head beat in 50 times in a row either. Although, like I said, I don't mind with this one. I don't mind the difficulty because I know what I'm getting into when I get into it. And I think that's where I like my difficulty in games, where I can change it to the point where I know what I'm at and I'm choosing what I want to do. So I think they've given you variable difficulty levels here, which is good. All right, Terrence. Well, that's all I got to say for tonight. We will be back next week where we play against Collector. And who knows if it's a fast one. If it's fast loss, we'll probably just play set him up, play him again. But if it's a fast one the other way, maybe we will go against the next villain, which is also Collector. So we'll see. we'll see. But yeah, we'll get into the story again next time. We'll wrap up the story from this one and then get into the story for the next one. But thanks. Oh, I just realized I didn't read the flavor text at the beginning of the scenario. Brotherhood of Badoon has mounted a surprise attack against Earth. You and the other Guardians of the Galaxy rush to Earth's aid, teaming up with the mighty Avengers in the process to beat back the Badoon. However, the Brotherhood of Badoon's leader, Drang, is a skilled tactician with the fleet of powerful ships and an overwhelming number of soldiers at his side. This won't be an easy fight. And it wasn't. It was just perfect. All right, Terrence.
A lot of ships. There were a lot of ships.
There were a lot of ships. Terrence, great seeing you as always, man. And we will do it next Friday.
Sounds good.
All right. Bye.
Bye.